company at Dr. Phillips Center. I'm not sure how many of you had the chance actually to come through the stage door. It is our stage door, but it's also, it's up for rent at the Kubersky lobby. And actually, everybody enters this door here that are going to be learning, are going to be teaching. Donors that come in here, board members, artists, it's actually quite a lovely space. Right behind here, too, is also our small rehearsal room that's also going to support arts and education. Today, it's doing double duty, actually, for family opera that is actually right backstage. So, again, thank you and welcome. We're here today to actually preview our School of the Arts inaugural season. It actually starts on January 5th, and registration for the classes is up and running. And to ensure SWOT, we need everyone in the community to understand that December 17th is the last week that you can sign up, so it's a fantastic Christmas gift. And it's not just for the little guys, it's just about anybody. So our classes are from 3 to even 103. And any student that signs up today through December will receive a Tupperware brand water bottle on the first day of class. And as you all know, Tupperware has been a wonderful advocate supporter of our project since day one, and we're glad that they're actually part of our educational initiative. It's also an exciting time for us at the Arts Center because we just finished the grand opening. We've gotten through the celebration of christening the theater. We're into our first production, and now our core mission has always been a center of excellence around arts education. And there's so much potential here because our team has the ability to take all the wonderful educational content and tie it in to a lot of the work and the artists that are already here. And we've already done a great deal of that already. We want to give you a chance to see, experience what the students are going to be doing. When they're here, right upstairs we have our classrooms. And today after we have our comments, we're going to invite you upstairs so you can be part and see part of the classes. And if you want to participate, you can jump in. We have beginning jazz dance that we're sharing today. Stretch and vocal performance instructors are also going to be ready to include you if you're interested. We're also very, very fortunate to observe the Yamaha Music School in two classes today. This partnership is wonderful. Another one of our donors was so great to actually introduce us to this program, Richard Kessler, of course. He's been fantastic. And Yamaha School of Music, they're in 40 countries, and they're all around the world. And they actually have been introducing people to music for over 50 years. And we're very fortunate that we're the authorized Yamaha Music School in Central Florida. And their music education program system offers effective and comprehensive training from kids from 3 to 8, and the results speak for themselves. The graduates and advocates and people that have actually started from this program are Grammy winners, international professional music competition winners. They're highly sought after teachers, over 6 million graduates from this program, and it's all here at the Dr. Phillips Center. But before we head upstairs, we're so grateful to have an executive committee member and board member and our champion that is really tied regionally into Osceola County and throughout the community and the world through Tupperware Brands, Mr. Tom Hull, and then also our Vice President of Program and Education at the Dr. Phillips Center, Scott Gallup, are going to come up here and share with you some of their comments. Thank you very much, guys. Tom Hull.
Thank you, Kathy, and I also want to welcome you to the Tupperware Brands Education Lobby. Tupperware, as Kathy said, is a big supporter of the Dr. Phillips Center for the Performing Arts. Generally, I think it does wonders for our community in general. But specifically, as to the School of Arts, it advances one of Tupperware's points of emphasis in its local social responsibility program, that being education of children. So Tupperware has, for a long time, had a continuing relationship with the Boys and Girls Clubs of America, with Junior Achievement, and even the Osceola County School for the Performing Arts, which used to be the Tupperware Convention Center right on our headquarters. So all of those contribute to our goal. And so the School of Arts, I think, helps us advance that cause in a really big way. So we're very proud to be associated with this, as well as helping the arts for every life.
Reiterate our thanks to Tom and your colleagues even before we launched the School of Arts, even before we had the Dr. Phillips Center grand premiere, our School of Arts team was collaborating with schools and students across Central Florida, and we've already had a huge impact for a number of programs, not the least of which are our 30 teen ambassadors from all over the region. They're all high school teen ambassadors. The Applause Awards, which celebrates excellence in high school musical theater. Our adjudication team has gone as far as Melbourne already, evaluating shows and offering constructive feedback. We have a partnership with Access Charter at OCA, through which we're creating a social story for guests on the autism spectrum. And that story will be about attending an arts center, helping them to get ready to come and enjoy performances here. Our Eye on Broadway initiative is for school-age visual artists, and their work will be displayed in our venue during specific touring Broadway productions. Some of those are on display now as part of the Phantom of the Opera. We have master classes with touring Broadway shows. The Phantom of the Opera master class is coming on and is completely sold out. We received a PNC grant that supports our partnership with the Connecticut Science Center. We received a national education grant from the Broadway League. And the list goes on and on. And in fact, it's a rather comprehensive list. So we have created a fact sheet for you to help you navigate all the various programs that you've got going on. So before we go farther, let me just take a moment to salute our director of education, Dan Brazil, and her assistant, they have created and started implementing all of these programs even before we opened our doors. So thank you very much for your hard work and your commitment to the community. So we are proud to have you as part of our team. Daniel will be leading us through the preview and will be available for questions afterwards. So as you go through the preview today and as you look through the School of Arts brochure, you'll notice the theme of innovation and collaboration that runs through everything that we do. Our School of Arts is offering up to 81 classes per week, and ranging from everything from creative dramatics for preschoolers to African drumming, rock band, magic, ukulele, yoga, and Zumba, not necessarily your traditional set of arts offerings. But again, in the interest of arts for every life, we have as broad and diverse a program as we possibly can. And along with that, we have foundational arts instruction for every actor, singer, dancer, and musician needs in order to thrive. And all from our exceptional faculty in this terrific venue. So we are delighted to have you here today and to have you experience our School of Arts. So without further ado, let's all pretend that the bell has rung and let's go to class. Thanks again.
In this classroom over here, we have Sarah Tellier. She is one of our Yamaha music instructors, and she's actually leading a junior musicians class with 3 to 5 year olds right now. At 11 o'clock, there will be a class change, and we will take a young musicians class, which is 6 to 8 year olds, and that is instruction. We also have keyboard classes for adults, or people who may not want integrated curriculum, so you could just sign up if you've ever had a passion, maybe want to learn piano, we'll have that over here. On this side, in this class studio, this is Studio 3, we have Priscilla Bagley. She's one of our vocal performance instructors, as well as our musical theater instructor. And she has a very comprehensive resume, following the arts at all in the community. She's a performer around the world.
There are over 100 teachers that actually apply to work here from all over the Central Florida area. And you probably had some of that. We had a bunch of that. And how many teachers do you have?
We have 32.
32 out of 100 teachers. Great job getting the best here for
And we're continuing to receive resumes, and as we do, we collect them, and as we move forward and staff more classes and different classes, we bring all those people into the back and see what their skills and gifts are. So it's something, a class they may be proficient at teaching may not be on our radar, and we might get excited. Watch a little bit if you'd like. So make yourselves at home.